Now, as we discussed, we need to add the connector of the chilled water and the drainage system for this H. So this is my entire face of the H. Okay, what I do to connect the chilled water when I go to the create, if you see the pipe connector here, to get the duct, we choose in the duct connector. But when I am choosing to the pipe connector, what will happen here? So this is my face of this H. Let's say I want to select by the tab. When I click on the face, this connector will go automatically center of the face. Okay, but according to our HU design, I should have the connectors like this. Let's say, for example, this is my chilled water pile area, top and bottom like this. To get this kind of the connectivity, I need to extrude the little part of the pipe in the H. Now I'm going to delete it. So in this area, let's say, for example, this is my coil area. Here I will do some extrusion. I will go to the create and extrude with the circular form. Let's say 100 mm radius. So I am going to the top view. So I want to see internal part. So I am going to the wireframe. So I can adjust my connector. Let's see, I am going to lock here. So why? When we change the width of the HU, it will automatically get updated. And I need the thickness of this connector. I will go to create and I take the one more reference plane to get it. Here I will align to it. Okay. Or else I will use align command to lock it. Lock. So if I want to maintain proper dimension, I will go to the dimension. Let's say 100 mm. 10 centimeters, or let's say 50 centimeters, 5 centimeters, 50 mm. I will lock it. It should be fixed. Right? Again, I am going to the front view. Now see. I want to mirror it, or I can copy it. Okay? So, always it should be diagonal shape. Right? So, now I am going to top view again. I want to align both. So why I'm going to lock it, you can understand. If I change the width of this duct, it will get updated. Let's say now I'm going to change the width to the 200. Okay, so like this, it will get updated. Right? Now, I want to give the connectors to this water. I will go to the create pipe connector. I'm going to click on the face of the circuit. Okay, this one is supply. I will go to the property and system classification. I will make it to the supply. Hydronics supply. Hydronics means chilled water. Okay, here we can change this pipe connector into any required discipline. Let's say hydronic supply, hydronic return, sanitary, vent pipe, domestic hot water, domestic cold water, firefighting, but any kind of the service we can define within the family and select the one more connector, go to the hydronics return. But coming to the diameter of this, let's say you can select it and the diameter you can make it 100 mm. So we have taken the radius to 100 mm. So now I will take the diameter to 200 mm. Select it, diameter. And I will load into the project. See, this side, I got the chilled water connection. For example, I want the chilled water connect that side. I need to assign these circles that side. And again, I want to give the drain pipe. Again, I am going to the family. So generally, so top view, I am going to front view. Drain pipe, I am going to give the some side of this area. Create. Extrusion same like, okay. This time I will take the small circle. Let's say 50 mm radius, 100 mm by, yeah. Okay. Again, same process. I will extend until this. lock it. I can lock it. Okay. I will go to the 3D view. See, now I go to this create pipe connector. I choose this connector. Okay. Here I will go to the 100 mm diameter. So what about the system? It should be sanitary drainage system. Select this connector and go to this system classification. Make it sanitary. Okay. Load into the file. Now if you see, one, I'm getting the sanitary. Sanitary means we will get this pipe fitting kind of the things. So Hydronics return and Hydronics supply. Correct. Now I need to draw the pipe, chilled water pipe. So I'm going to the second level because my AHU in the second level. Correct. Here to draw the pipe, I will go to the section. So already I have the section. I want to use the same section. Like, okay. Select it and go to the view. This is my crop boundary. I can increase. Let's say this is my supply, chilled water supply. To draw the chilled water pipe, same like duct only. Okay. Let's say now I am going to the system. If I want to draw duct, I will choose a duct. If I want to draw the pipe, I will go to the pipe. Okay. Here I can choose the pipe. Same option. If you observe carefully, here we have the duct, here we have the pipe. Here we have the pipe fittings, duct fittings, and here we have the pipe fittings. Here we have the accessories, here we have the walls. There will be no change. Okay. I choose in the pipe. When I choose the pipe, I will get the diameter and elevation of the pipe. So now I am in the section. So I elevation, I can choose myself. That is the reason it is a disabled. So here I have the 200 mm pipe. I want to draw the 200 mm pipe. Let's say I want to choose the 200 mm diameter of the pipe. Okay. What classification I need to give the supply? Hydronic supply. Right. Here we need to choose the type of the pipe. Let's say now I am going to use chilled water pipe. This is one type. If you want to create your own, you can make it and duplicate, you can create your own. This is common practice for anything. If you want to create new according to your own standard, just to go to edit type and select a duplicate. Okay. Let's say now I am going to chilled water. See, if you go in detail about the chilled water pipe materials and all, here you can see the pipe segment, steel carbon, schedule 40, diameter 20. Where we will assign these pipe materials is, if you go to the edit type, here you have the routing preferences. Here you can see the steel carbon pipe. In the pipe segment, you can change it. If you want to change it, you can select it. Okay. So in the routing preference only, we can change whatever you want. Just to go by one, okay? Nothing to worry about. Then I'm going to the connective. When I move near to my AHU pipe, I'm getting the node snap. I will click it, okay? Just, I'm going to draw like this. This is a horizontal. And I want to draw the chilled water return, Hydronics return. This is my return pipe. Can you check it? This is my return pipe. Okay. Again, I am going to the second level. So let's say this is now both pipe looks the same, but which one is the return, which one is supply, I don't know. Correct? If you select this pipe in the property, you can see the system type Hydronics return. If you go to the select this pipe, it is showing the system type Hydronics supply. Here I want to differentiate with the different colors. Supply is one color, return is one color. Then what I need to do, again I need to create the filters for the pipes. Yesterday we did filters for the duct. Now we need to create the filter for the pipe. To create the filters, I will go to the visibility graphics view, visibility graphics, filters, Okay, here you can see the domestic sanitary pad, but we don't have the chilled water pad. Let's say now I am going to create a new one. Right? See, already we have anything. HVAC supply, Adronics there. But I want to create my own. New. Let's say chilled water. CHW chilled water. Supply one filter. For the pipes. Yesterday I created for the duct. Now I am going to create the pipe accessories, pipes and pipes. Okay. Then I will go here. We have a lot of parameters to use. Yesterday we used comment. Today I am going to use a system type. System classification or system name. System type I want to use. System type. Let's say chilled water supply. CHWA supply equal to chilled water hydronic supply. So try to understand the filters how I'm going to create. You can try with all these parameters. Okay. Now I'm going with the system type hydronic supply. Okay. I'm going to add it. Hydronic supply. Here I want to give this color pattern. Hydronic supply solid and color is, let's say, green. Okay. Now we can see the green. Okay. In same way, I can create for the return also. Filters. So filters are very important. See, if I want to switch off this pipe, if you switch off this visibility, it will get disappear. We can use like a layer. Okay. Now I am going to create one more. New, okay. Again, I'm going to create new chilled water return. Okay, for the pipes, pipe accessories, pipe fittings, and pipes. System type equal to and hydronics return. This one, I want to add it. Hydrogen water return. Okay. For this, I want to give the different color. Return, I want to use this. Okay. We have did something wrong. Right? Filters. So I given the color to sanitary. Today also I did mistake again. You should be careful. Right? For the sanitary, I want to assign. Now check. Okay. Now we can create our pipe routing. I want to create. Select it. Create similar. You can draw whatever. This is one more pipe and select it, right click, create similar, you will get the same. Okay. Go to the 3D view. Let me see. So I assign the filter in the plan view. Filters are applicable only for respective view. You should remember. If you want to get the same colors, we need to create the view template. Right? This time I want to draw the vertical pipe. This is my water pipe. See. These are my pipes. Select it. Can I see? I'm going to take section in this way. For this pipe only. Go to view. I'm going to find and shade. If I want to take this pipe, selected Radha Pai. So if you want to draw the vertical pipes, we should go into the section and draw vertical. Next, I am going to draw one more this pipe. I want to take another direction. Draw pipe. We can rotate according to our requirement. So in this way, we need to draw the pipes. Let's say for these pipes, I want to add my valves. If you go to the system, here you can see the accessories. Select it. So here we don't have the loaded families. We need to load it. Library, metric, pipe accessories. It's a different kind of the valves. Pressure gauges. Here we have the valves different folder. Let's say three-way valve, butterfly valve, check valve, ball valves. Now I'm going to use the ball valve. Select it. So just place on the pipe. Okay. If you select this valve, you can see the sizes here. If you change the size, it will increase. Okay. If you go to the floor plan, you can see this direction. You want to create similar, you can place on this rectangle. Okay, so wherever we want, we can place it. If I want to place in the vertical, go there. I want to place in vertical also. Select the system and walls, place. Let's say change the size of the wall. So you can choose, you can load any kind of the walls. Go to the inset. It's a family. So now I hope everybody can understand now. Whatever we are placing, it is a component. It's a family. We are creating the 3D block and placing in the Revit. Nothing else. Load into the project. Let's say instead of the ball walls, I want to use a butterfly wall. I want to change this wall into the butterfly. Select it. Select the butterfly wall into that one. We want to make it place here. Go to the system, choose the accessories to the butterfly wall. Just place on this, select it. Okay. Change the size according to the pipe size, you will change it. If you see in 3D, pressure gauges, anything you can make. Let's say now I want to assign the color in the 3D also. Just I will create the one new template here. Okay. Create from the current view. Let's say here I am going to shield wall. Now I will go to the 3D. Here I will go to the properties. In the view templates, I can assign the shield water view template. So you can see colors in the, how we have the colors in this floor plan, same colors you will get. Okay, so we can do like this. And coming to the drain pipe. Okay, we need to connect this drain pipe also. Go to the section. See, here we have the drain pipe. So what I do, instead of this, I will go to this project in the second floor. So if I take this section out of these pipes, I am getting all three pipes. I want to draw only drain pipe. I will choose my section up to this part. Right click and go to this. Okay. Now we can draw. Now. Select this, click on the symbol, directly you will get the drain pipe. Wherever you want take this drain pipe, you can take it. If I want to take outside, I can take it. Let me see. Where is my file? Set a draw name. We go to the visibility graphics. Always remember one thing: this after using the view template, just make it none. Here our drainage system is switched off. I think go to the visibility graphics filter. So we switched off the sanitary. If you click it, here we can see the sanitary. You can route wherever you want this sanitary pipes. It's clear. So process is very simple. Take the pipe, choose the system, draw whatever you want in which elevation you want.